Michelle just did a video about how we need to normalize that people need to eat more food, that eating a high calorie amount is not absurd, not ridiculous, and actually can be realistic and sustainable for a lot of people. And the times that I get the most kickback on this actually is in individuals who are shorter. So inevitably I get the question or concern of someone who's 5 feet tall or 5 foot one saying, you know, there's no way I could eat that much because I'm so short. So of course, today I want to share with you a case study of someone who that is not the case for. This person is short, she's 5 foot one, but she is losing weight eating 2200 to 2300 calories. So let's dive right into her case. Now, as I mentioned, this person is 5 foot one, and as you can see here, based on her metabolic test results at her initial visit, her metabolism is looking great. Her resting metabolic rate is 1574, which is right about, if not a little bit higher than what we would predict it to be, and her protein substrate utilization is normal, meaning that her body is not chipping into her muscle as an additional source of fuel. Now, what's really good about this particular case is that this person had not been dieting or restricting their intake before coming in to see us. This person did want to make some nutrition changes, but before doing them on her own, she decided, you know what, I'm just going to go right to the source. I'm going to go see a dietitian and have them help me. And honestly, I think that was a really great decision because, of course, her metabolic rate is nice and high, her protein substrate is normal, and we don't have to spend time correcting that metabolic rate or even working really on her relationship with food per se, because she hasn't really been doing any chronic dieting or restrictive intake or anything like that. Now, of course, I know that that's not the case for everybody, but this person is very fortunate that she hadn't done those things to date. So this person, because her resting metabolic rate was 1574, we had to add for the fact that she was just getting up and moving around, not exercise, but just getting up and moving around, and we had to add for her exercise amount. Now, this particular individual is doing about an hour and a half to 2 hours of exercise almost every day, not quite 7 days a week, but anywhere from 5 to 6 days a week, and it varied of what she did. Sometimes it was running, sometimes it was walking, sometimes it was horseback riding, sometimes it was going to the gym, but she was a very active person. So this person's total daily needs, when we take into account, again, resting metabolic rate of 1574, adding for just getting up and moving around, and then also adding for what she was burning during exercise, her total daily needs were about 2,500. A little bit higher, but 2,500 calories, right? So we recommended that she eat about 2,200 to 2,300 calories a day. Remember, you don't want to create a huge calorie deficit. When you try to make these massive calorie deficits is when, yeah, you might lose weight pretty quickly in the beginning, but ultimately that's going to plateau and it's not going to be sustainable because your body's going to start to compensate, most notably by bringing down that metabolic rate. So in order to prevent that metabolic rate from coming down, we want to keep only a small calorie deficit. So the goal here is for her to eat about 2,200 to 2,300 calories a day. And hopefully what that'll do is cause her fat mass to come down some, but maintain this metabolic rate of 1574. Or maybe it'll even come up a little bit, but we don't want it to drop. So now let's take a look at what that did to her actual body composition. So as you can see here at baseline, this person is 5 foot one and 160 pounds, right? And this is when she first came in to see us and we saw that her metabolic rate was great. And remember, right off the bat, we recommended she eat about 2,200 to 2,300 calories a day, given all of those things that I just mentioned with her total daily needs, et cetera. So she started eating 2,200 to 2,300 calories a day, and look at her body composition. It's just perfectly sustainable. So the things that I want to point out here is one, her lean mass, that lean mass number is coming up, which is a great thing, right? That means that she's still building lean mass and muscle with the exercise that she's doing, and she's not losing that lean mass or muscle from under eating. Of course, what you can see here too is that her fat mass has come down pretty significantly from eating 2,200 to 2,300 calories a day as an individual who is 5 foot one. I can't stress that enough. Now, the other cool thing that I want to point out about this body composition is, as you can see, it looks like she's only lost 6 pounds of scale weight, right? Which some people would find that very discouraging in this time period of March to June. but she's lost a lot more fat mass. Her lean mass has come up, and that's what's so important to note. I think when you use the scale weight as your only marker of success, it can really throw you off and make it seem like you're not doing things right. And that's when people tend to sort of panic and start decreasing their intake. So let me just reiterate, this body composition here is a 5'1 individual eating 2,200 to 2,300 calories a day, and we're seeing amazing progress in changing her lean mass and fat mass. So I wanted to share this quick case study with you guys today because, again, I think it's a very common misconception that just because you're short means you need to eat very little calories, and that is not the case. You can be short and still need a lot of calories. Our bodies are designed that food is fuel, and we need to fuel our bodies for everything that it's doing in a day, and you don't want to be too restrictive regardless of what your size or shape may currently be. Don't forget to like and subscribe, guys. Thank you so much for being here.